Leeds International School, Form 2, Second Term, Science, Chapter 7, Microorganisms and Us. Objectives of the lesson. At the end of this lesson, you will be identifying about microorganisms, recognize the use of microorganisms in food production, understand about how microorganisms can cause decay, and also understand about the work of Louis Pasteur. Now let's see what are microorganisms. Microorganisms are living things that are too small to be seen with the naked eye. They are normally viewed using a microscope. In previous chapter, we talk about the living things and their characteristics. Living things share seven basic characteristics such as reproduction, sensitivity, movement, growth, nutrition, respiration, and excretion. Microorganisms include bacteria, protozoa, algae, and fungi are considered as living organisms because they also have these seven characteristics. Although viruses are not considered living organisms, they are classified as microorganisms. In this lesson, we are going to learn about microorganisms. So first of all, we have to know what are these microorganisms. Microorganisms are living things that are too small to be seen with the naked eye. They are normally viewed using a microscope. Microorganisms are organisms that are microscopic. The study of microorganisms is called microbiology. In previous lesson, we learned about living things. Living things share seven basic characteristics such as reproduction, sensitivity, movement, growth, nutrition, respiration, and excretion. Microorganisms include bacteria, protozoa, algae, and fungi are considered as living organisms because they also have these seven characteristics. Although viruses are not considered living organisms, they are classified as microorganisms. Microorganisms are found all around us and even inside our body. Microorganisms live in water, in soil, and on the skin and in the digestive tract of animals. Many microorganisms can be helpful to them. Some can be harmful and cause diseases. Now, let's learn about growing microorganisms. A characteristic of microorganisms is the ability to grow and form a population of organisms. Microorganisms can be grown in a controlled environment. Handling microorganisms safely requires specific techniques. Growing and studying microorganisms give us vital information about their rapid growth and their possible uses. Bacteria are a fascinating type of microorganisms that play a large role in our lives whether we like it or not. Try growing your own sample of bacteria while monitoring how it reproduces in a short space of time with the help of your science teacher. The agar plate and warm conditions provide the ideal place for bacteria to grow. The microorganisms on the plate will grow into individual colonies. Agar plates are created by pouring hot molten agar into sterile petri dishes, which is then allowed to set. Bacteria can be spread onto the plates and allowed to form individual colonies of the specific bacteria. Different samples of bacteria provide different results. After learning about how to make agar plates, let's learn about how to grow bacteria on a nutrient agar plate. There are a few steps in growing of bacteria. The first one, prepare the agar according to the direction on the label, then pour enough to cover the bottom of each petri dish. Cover the dishes and let them stand for about an hour until the agar has solidified.
When your petri dishes are ready, collect some bacteria. Using aseptic method, transfer the bacteria onto the egg plates. Seal the plates with paraffin after the bacteria are introduced. The egg plates are then kept at a temperature of 28 degrees Celsius overnight. At last, label all petri dishes with your name, class, date and name of the organism. And in next day morning, you can observe colonies of bacteria as shown in below diagram. In microbiology, aseptic techniques essentially requires only common sense and good laboratory skills. First, consider that every surface you touch and the air that you breathe may be contaminated by microorganisms. Now let's see how we use these aseptic techniques to avoid contamination. An inoculating loop can be used to transfer bacteria. It is sterilized by heating it to red hot in a Bunsen flame before and after use. To inoculate the agar, lift the lid of the petri dish and tilt. Do not fully remove or place on the desk as the lid prevents microorganisms from the air contaminating the culture. Microorganisms can be used in food production also. Now let's learn about yeast in food production. Yeast is a microscopic organism which converts sugar into alcohol and carbon dioxide. And also, yeast is a little single cellular organism that we use to bake with. Yeast need both warm environment and food to grow. The process is often called proofing the yeast. It should be dissolved in warm water but not hot water or it will die. Sugar is usually added to feed and grow the yeast. You should see activity within 5 minutes, bubbling and expansion during yeast activation. If you see no activity, your yeast is too old or the water was too warm or too cold. Hence, in bread making, the bread dough containing yeast are often left in a warm place. When the gas get caught in the bread dough, when it is proving, the air pockets get caught in the dough and cause the bread to rise and be light. Other than yeast, there are some more microorganisms used in food production. From this slide, you will get an idea about those microorganisms. Bacteria and molds are used to produce some of foods that we eat. Various dairy products can be made from milk such as yogurt and cheese. They are made by adding a mixture of lactic acid bacteria to the milk. These bacteria are called lactobacillus. Milk contains a type of sugar known as lactose. By adding lactobacillus to the milk, milk starts to ferment and during the fermentation process, a proportion of the lactose naturally is converted to lactic acid. Because of the lactic acid, milk gets thickened and tastes sour. In cheese production, different types of bacteria and molds are often added to achieve the unique flavor of each type of cheese. Now let's move on to microorganisms as decomposers. In ecosystems, microorganisms play a very important role as decomposers. When you have an empty bottle, do you recycle it so the plastic or glass can be used again? Nature has its own recycling system, a group of organisms called decomposers. They perform a valuable service as Earth's cleanup crew. Decomposers are like living garbage disposals. When something dies, the decomposers take over from there. They eat dead remains and are even known as nature's cleaners. Decomposers play a critical role in the flow of energy through an ecosystem.
Most decomposers are microscopic organisms, including protozoa and bacteria. Fungi are important decomposers, especially in forests. Some kinds of fungi, such as mushrooms, look like plants. Microorganisms can cause infectious diseases. An infectious disease is any disease caused by a pathogen such as a virus, bacteria, parasite, or fungus. Different kinds of pathogens cause different kinds of diseases. Here are some example diseases caused by each type of pathogen. Viruses. Viruses are extremely small and consist of DNA with a protective coating of protein. Diseases caused by viruses include influenza, the common cold, measles, yellow fever, and hepatitis. Bacteria. Bacteria are small organisms. They can cause diseases such as tuberculosis, cholera, typhoid fever, and tetanus. Parasites. Parasites are organisms that live off their hosts. Some parasitic diseases include malaria, sleeping sickness, and scabies. At last, fungi. Fungi are microorganisms such as yeast and molds. They can cause diseases such as fungal meningitis, ringworm, and thrush. When we talk about microorganisms and microbiology, Louis Pasteur is a main character. Louis Pasteur is a French scientist in the 19th century. He is known as the father of microbiology because of his remarkable discoveries in the 1880s. He and his wife, Maria, are best known for their experiments supporting the germ theory of diseases, and he is also known for his vaccinations, most notably the first vaccine against rabies. He is best known for the discovery of vaccinations, pasteurization, fermentation, and proving that germ cause diseases. Pasteurization. Pasteur used his knowledge of germs to investigate how beverages such as wine and milk were spoiled by microorganisms such as bacteria and molds. He found that heating up the liquids would kill most of the microorganisms and allow the beverages to last longer and be safer to drink. This process became known as pasteurization and is still done on many foods such as milk, vinegar, wines, cheese, and juices. Vaccinations. Pasteur continued to investigate with diseases. He found that he could make a weak form of disease that would cause people to become immune to the stronger from the disease. He called this weak form a vaccine. Fermentation. Fermentation is a chemical change used to make bread, wine, cheese, and other foods. Okay, children. Now, do these questions in your writing copy. Summary of the lesson. Microorganisms include viruses, bacteria, fungi, protozoa. Microorganisms are living things and microscopic. Microorganisms can be divided into two as harmful organisms and useful organisms. Harmful organisms can spread
This spread is prevented by washing hands, sterilizing. Harmful organisms, as they cause diseases such as tuberculosis, AIDS, malaria, etc. Somehow scientists develop cures to these diseases. Useful organisms. Useful organisms used by people to make food, medicines. Useful organisms in ecosystems role in decomposing to recycle nutrients. This is the end of the video, and thank you for listening.